Very good evening, fellow Toastmasters and distinguished guests.
Good evening.
Ek dusre se karte hai pyar hum. Ek dusre se karte hai pyar hum. Now these lines are from the Hindi movie Hum, which was very famous in the 1990s. And it means that we are there for each other and you can count on us. Fellow Toastmasters and friends, who all, just raise your hands, who all like, love your extended families as much as your own family. Yes? I can see a lot of hands.
Brilliant.
Yes. It was in the year, December 2010. I had been to Gandhidham, my native place in Gujarat, to see, visit my extended family, which consists of my uncle, aunties, my grandparents, my nieces, my nephews, mama, mummies, cha-cha, cha-chis, a whole lot of them. The Gujarati culture, they are famous for their love, affection and warmth towards each other, just like any other cultures. So, one Sunday afternoon, sultry Sunday afternoon, I had been out with my Masi's three little children, Raj, Araf and Jia, for a long drive. They were singing in the car, Ek dusre se karte hai pyar hum, you know, with a lot of mistakes, and I was enjoying watching them. It was a treat to watch and hear them sing. The streets were very narrow, with a lot of potholes, muddy potholes, and the roads were not in a good shape. I parked my car, it was a Hyundai 8N red car, I had parked it at the gas station. I was outside the gas station when a man, the unkempt, ghastly looking, red, blood-red eyes man approached me. Hey lady, give me your purse, he yelled at me. Just go away, you crazy man, I told him. He just jumped into the car, intent on stealing it. I screamed out, help, help. I looked all around, there was nobody around. Left and right. I became panic stricken. I was worried about the three children in the car. I yelled at them, Rajia, get out of the car, Arav, get out. But Arav, he was small, he was only 3 years old, he was still strapped in the car. Raj somehow managed to get out of the car, the 6 year old. Jia, the 4 year old, I pulled her out. But the little toddler was still strapped in the car, and the man got out. I started running. I was panic stricken. I was paralyzed with fear. I started running along the car to get in control of the steering wheel. He picked up speed, got onto the street. I didn't let go of the steering wheel. I was dragged and dragged on the narrow streets. He started hitting my face, punching my face, but still I didn't let go of the car, of the steering wheel. I was being dragged again and again, but no, I could see Araf, the baby, the crying loudly. I couldn't take it, my heart was bleeding. I didn't let go. I somehow managed to get through the driver's windowsill and started yelling at the top of my voice, get out of the car, you creep, get out of the car. This man again started punching me. I didn't let go. I took all the thrashes. My eyes were constant on the baby. Enough is enough. He couldn't take it anymore. Phew! He just was about to flee. I caught his collar. Got him out of the car and started punching his face. By the time people gathered all around, and I gave him to them, they started hitting him left, right, and center. They didn't leave him. I ran towards Araf, hugged him tightly, and told him, please, please don't cry. He was crying at the top of his voice. I said, everything will become fine. And I was worried for both of them at the gas station. So I drove the car as fast as I could. They were there. They were shivering. They were panic stricken. They were worried. They had tears. They were screaming. Mercy, mercy! I ran towards them. I hugged them tightly. Baby, please don't cry. Everything will be fine, everything. They were shivering. I hugged them so tightly. I wanted to pacify them, console them. I just went out, picked up some chocolate sweets and gave it to them. They were okay. It was late at 6:30. There were so many phone calls. But I couldn't take it. I reached home. They were furious with me. They were angry. They were worried for the kids. I just collapsed onto the chair. I drank water and explained to them each and everything what had happened. They were speechless. At that moment, Aravind, Jia, and Raj came running towards me and hugged me tightly and said, "Love you." That was it. I felt contented. I felt relieved. I felt, yes. Yes, I have protected my children. They are like my children. My masa, masis, my uncle, aunties, they just patted me and said, "Shabash Dikri," which meant in Gujarati, which means in English, "You have come a long way." Friends, Toastmasters, there is a hero in each and every one of you. Please remember that. Over to you. Come.